Hello, and welcome to episode 4 of Focused on You. They've kept us around for 4 episodes. We must be doing something right. Either that or no one's listening and it doesn't matter.
I'm hungry.
We'll see. There we go. I'm your host, Jay Sanford, Director of Investment Strategy at WFG. In today's episode, and this is something I've been looking forward to talking about, we're going to answer the question, who is the funniest person at WFG? But before we do that, a word from our good folks at Compliance.
The opinions voiced in this program are for general information only and are not intended to provide specific advice or recommendations for any individual. To determine which investments may be appropriate for you, consult with your attorney, accountant, financial or tax advisor prior to investing. Securities offered through LPL Financial, member FINRA, SIPC. Investment advice offered through Global Retirement Partners LLC, a registered investment advisor. Global Retirement Partners, LPL Financial and Washington Financial Group are separate non-affiliated entities.
And now that compliance is taken care of, we can really tear the door down here when it comes to who is the funniest at WFG. I am joined today by the president of WFG, Jeff Hamlin. Jeff, thanks for coming by.
Always happy. Present.
And Mark Jensen, associate at WFG. Thanks, Mark, for coming.
They still haven't kicked me off the podcast yet.
We're working on it. Don't worry. All right. Funniest person at WFG. I have been thinking about this ever since this topic came up in our emails, which you neither of you looked at until this morning. So thank you for doing that.
My pleasure.
Why don't we start with Mark? Who do you think the funniest person at WFG is?
Well, since I can't nominate myself, I'm going to go with who we refer to as the fun police, Mr. Jay Sanford.
Because I can't argue with that.
He's a pretty good trash talker. If you've ever been in a fantasy football league with him or done an NCAA bracket, he usually doesn't end up winning, but he'll tell you he's the greatest the whole way. So at least he keeps it really
entertaining. Do you consider that funny? I don't know if that's funny at all.
He always throws my food away in the refrigerator.
That I do because it smells.
I like science projects.
Jeff, what do you think? Funniest person. Now, and that really can mean a lot of different things, right? I mean, some people tell good jokes. Some people tell funny stories. What do you think?
Well, first of all, I don't think it's so funny when I like to take naps in the Serenity Room afternoon that you guys are rapping on the door.
This is true.
Right? So leave me out of it. Or when I like to change from my hot yoga. Oof. So leave me alone.
We will.
No question. Mr. Joe DeNoyer is the funniest guy in this office when he's on a roll. I mean, here is this heavyset New Yorker coming down talking about the best pizza, and he's always right about everything. Is he ever wrong?
That's a good point.
It's just a laugh a minute every time that guy comes out, right?
So I would agree with you on that. I've thought about this. He's by far the best person at telling funny stories. I mean, all of the meetings that he's in, whether you're in them or not, you hear laughter coming from that meeting.
And They're never true.
His story about you in the steam room is absolutely true, and it is a very funny story. But I think he tells the funniest stories. I will say there are a few people. So Mark Jensen and Tom Leveroni, very dry humor. So if you find yourself in a team meeting, they're dropping one-liners under their breath all the time. Very, very funny.
How about Nicole?
Nicole, not funny at all. And she probably would admit to that. We do have a new team member, Elena, who I think is the practical joker of the crew now. I started out, she's an Arsenal fan, you know, when it comes to soccer, and Mark makes fun of soccer no matter what. And I'm a Chelsea fan, so the first time they played each other when she was in the office, I thought I was funny, and I draped a Chelsea flag on her chair. Well, I quickly learned that you never, ever play a practical joke on a millennial who has a computer and Photoshop, because I came in the next day, my office was complete with Arsenal emblems all over it, and basically fat heads of Arsenal players with my face transposed on every player. So I immediately stopped the practical joke war with her. So I would say she has become kind of the practical joker of the crew. Jeff Hamblin, quite frankly, you're the life of every party that I've been to. And so that may or may not be funny per se, but it sure does provide a lot of laughs for everyone around you.
When clothes are optional, I'm in.
As I said, every time he's out, it is a good time.
And when Lena put that whoopee cushion on my seat, that was a laugh.
There you have it. Our first flatulence joke on the podcast, episode 4. So to wrap it up and not to belabor this, I think we have a very, very funny office. And funny comes in a lot of different sizes and packages. And we're really lucky to be in an environment where we feel comfortable playing those jokes, telling those stories, and having a good time. I think it's a good balance here at WFG.
I'll definitely vouch that Elena owns Jay, and he will never tease her again.
Accurate. 100%.
And my comedy does not translate to podcasts, so don't judge me too severely until we meet again in person.
And there is Mark Jetson, associate. So thank you guys for coming by. I appreciate you having fun with this one. Jeff, any last words?
Well, we've got this awesome kitchen now where we all meet together, so it's even better than it ever was before because now we can cut on each other all the time.
That's true. Very true. Thanks, Jeff. Mark, any last words?
This will be my last podcast ever. Thank you for having me.
And thank you all for listening. We truly appreciate it. If you have a question that you'd like us to address in future episodes, shoot us an email at info@washfinancial.com. Thanks for listening to Wash In Financial Group's Focused on You podcast. Connect with us at washfinancial.com. If you enjoy our show, we'd love for you to subscribe on iTunes or wherever you access your podcast. Until next time, thanks for listening.